we're back, and I brought friends. I brought lots of friends. I've got friends from Intel, friends from Microsoft. We'll start with you, Keicha, from Microsoft. Good to see you. I've got my friend Nuri here from Intel. And then we are going way back. We're going way back to yesterday. So Rob and I have this huge thing going all the way back to yesterday. Glad to see all of you. How are we? Welcome to Build. All right. Nuri, I'm going to you, kicking us off here. We've talked a lot about AI PC. So let's talk about what's new with AI PC, in particular as it relates to developer readiness.
Absolutely. So we are so excited about like getting that new category of devices. Yesterday, Satya's announcement about the Copilot Plus PCs, it means a lot for Intel because we try to really bring AI everywhere and to PCs. For developers, this is a tremendous opportunity. Sam yesterday on stage mentioned that this is like another dot-com moment for developers to develop applications for the AI era. And especially on Intel side with our Intel Core Ultra processors, we provide CPU, GPU, and NPU for developers to develop applications on the PC itself. So this will unlock like tremendous opportunities in the market. We will see a lot of great innovation, I believe, and we will mention that DirectML and many others that Intel and Microsoft has been working on it for many years before.
Talk a little bit about why is now the time for AI PC?
Yeah, I mean, this is really like, I mean, if you look at the pace of innovation, AI is happening everywhere because if you look at the growth of AI in the couple of months, not years, like it has started on the cloud, like there's a lot of large language models, but now like an AI PC can run up to 500 different large language models. And also you have seen on Satya's keynote yesterday, SLMs are big things. So like we want to make sure the developers are getting the right tools, which is the AI PC on their hand to develop the solutions. Just before us, Mark was on stage highlighting the security, especially from a security standpoint. We want to make sure the developers has the power to control their AI development on their PC right in front of them.
And so getting developers ready for this is super important for you, right? Excellent, excellent. We'll just ask the blunt question. Why should developers care about this right now?
I think it's all about the potential market growth. Like, I mean, we know that by 2030, Gen AI specifically alone will be a $1 trillion market. So the developers should develop for these devices. I will mention a number, which is like Intel will ship 100 million Core Ultra devices in the next 18 months. So that's a massive opportunity for developers. You know, like this is a new like 100 million devices that will be using the power of AI.
Scale, scale, scale,
exactly.
more. All right, Keicha, I'm going to bring you into this picture.
Absolutely.
And you work on DirectML.
I do.
So talk a bit about DirectML, how it helps developers build AI experiences on these types of devices.
Yeah, absolutely. So we know Windows supports a diverse hardware ecosystem, which provides many options, right, for developers to choose to optimize and integrate their AI experiences. And it was recognized that this really poses unique challenges when we talk about scale across this ecosystem, right, and really bringing the power to the developer to reach the breadth of their customers on Windows. And so as we heard Satya and Pavan mention yesterday, DirectML is a key foundational component of the Windows Copilot runtime, right? With DirectML, we really uniquely simplify scale because we provide a single cross-hardware DirectX API that just provides that consistent, secure, performant experience across the different hardware architectures. DirectML supports and works with popular machine learning frameworks like Onyx Runtime, and you heard PyTorch yesterday. And we're really excited about the web, you know, bringing the scale to the web with the web and end developer preview. DirectML works today across Windows GPUs, and we're partnering with our hardware vendor partners like Intel to bring the same scale and experience off the with the new NPUs that you find on the Copilot Plus PCs.
Very cool. Talk a little bit more about the role that Intel plays and the relationship between Microsoft and Intel as it relates to this work.
Yeah, that's actually a fantastic question, right? So what do I really mean, or what do we really mean when we say DirectML scales across hardware? With DirectML, we really focus on abstracting out the hardware-specific details so the developer really doesn't have to know every type of PC their customer may have. And really for that to be possible with DirectML is dependent on our close partnerships with our hardware vendors like Intel. And, you know, just speaking a little bit about that, it's really vital to work with Intel, right? Because while we focus on scale with DirectML, it has to work really well and work work as expected on their hardware. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, if you tuned in to the stage yesterday, Intel did a great demo of the WebNN technology where we've been partnering with Khan Academy and Intel here to bring WebNN developer preview powered by DirectML to customers. It's coming soon.
I love that demo. I mean, I was a little partial because I was on stage and I was like, this is really cool. And then they disconnected it and it was not on the internet. I even talked about it this morning. That's pretty awesome. So Rob, let's talk now. It's time for us to chat. Let's start with some of the key things developers need to know when they're developing AI on Intel, particularly with this partnership with Microsoft.
Absolutely. So, see, there is this new thing called NPU.
Yep.
A lot of developers don't know what it means, how to write apps for it, right? And that's why many, many years back, we started working with the team at Microsoft, the Windows AI team, to develop an API and work towards that API that developers can start targeting without really knowing the complexities of the hardware underneath it. They can write the same app, and the same app that they're familiar with in the DirectX ecosystem, and the same APIs they can target using GPU and NPU. With one single line of code, magic happens. The workload will move from GPU to NPU, and you can start using it in that manner. So that consistent API and underneath consistent numerics that are well understood by developers, like things like FP16, that's a very important piece of Intel's NPU, where the same numerics that you're used to of seeing in the graphics world is what you're using for AI in this world too. So, and then you have, of course, the power saving of Int8 numerics that comes into that place. So that consistent experience and then availability of tools like PIX that they're familiar with. They're familiar with VTune from Intel. So you can work towards finding accuracy issues, performance issues in an ecosystem that a developer finds familiarity with.
Earlier today, particularly downstairs in the keynote, we talked a lot about security and security being a team sport. Talk a little bit about how this kind of plays into it, in particular, our team members of developers.
Absolutely. So this is something very important. I think Mark also emphasized on it a minute back. When we are bringing these models onto a device, reliability is very important. We want to make sure that we are not bringing offensive content, like some of the things that we were showing. When you're interacting with the model, bad things can actually happen. We need to prepare for it. So in fact, we have a demonstration of that, the prompt injection attack, on how you can deliver reliability on a platform without sacrificing performance. So we have worked with Microsoft in enabling some of those foundational technologies to ensure you don't sacrifice performance to get more reliability in the platform.
Mm-hmm. And security moving kind of back down a little bit, down into that hardware type layer. Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah, excellent. Okay, I understand, they're telling me that we have a video and you want to chat a little bit about the video. Should we roll that now and we go ahead and have a chat?
Absolutely, let's do that. So what you're seeing here is, you have a photos directory, a bunch of images lying around here. And I searched here, there is no images of a city. And now I just went and downloaded an image of a city. I saved it in my gallery. I just named it some random thing. And now what you're seeing is the image of the city is showing up. Right now, just for the purpose of the demo, we clicked on Analyze Now, and you see the utilization of NPU slightly go up because it's not a very intensive workload, so it's just slightly going up. It cataloged that image is of a city. Now when I do a search of city, bingo, you find it. So what we're trying to show here is underneath it, there is DirectML running. Mm-hmm. The platform that you're buying is showing, it is actually available today in Best Buy. It's a partner team. We have OEM called Samsung, which is what is using this. They are deploying this thing today. Okay. DirectML is ready for developers today to start targeting in the language that they're familiar with. Being part of DirectML means you can go with the language of your choice, right? Because it's .NET. So you're able to target all your languages and be able to start using it today.
Yeah, one of the cool things I'll add to that was when we were talking about scaling DirectML to NPUs, Intel was one of the first key partners we went with, and we were able to deploy the developer preview. So we'll have more availability coming soon as we target Copilot Plus PCs.
That is awesome. I love when those partnerships spawn the things and we can gather the knowledge. Nuri, let me ask you, where do you see developer readiness going in the next 12 to 24 months, particularly around AI PC?
Absolutely. So we are excited to partner with Microsoft on many of the activities. One of them is the AI tours. We have been a sponsor for all the AI tours happened. I've been personally into many of them, so we are excited for that partnership. But we will increase that intensity with Microsoft, so we will be up until Ignite. I think we will have more 10 cities reaching out with Microsoft team. And also on the Intel side, we will have Intel AI tours, so we are also trying to help developers and be where they are. So like they should expect like more in like in-person training, but also we are increasing our awareness online. So Intel Developer Zone on intel.com will have a lot of details for the developers to develop applications for AI PC. Because as I said, like we already ship more than 5 million Core Ultra processor AI PCs, and like the remaining 95 million will be like a hockey stick effect in the market. So we want developers to be ready for the next evolution in this AI PC era.
So I'm going to ask each one of you, so I'll give you seconds to think about this. So the last thing that you want developers or our audience to hear based on these conversations, so Keicha, from the Microsoft standpoint and the stuff with the ML stuff that you're working on, what are kind of the key points that you want to make sure everybody lands?
Yeah, so definitely that the foundation of AI from a Microsoft perspective, I think about it for enabling these PCs, is really allowing developers to come as they are. So with DirectML and being part of the Windows Copilot runtime, we support popular frameworks that they can come and use. We support across our hardware vendors like Intel. We support across GPUs today, and we're expanding to this the additional accelerators like NPUs and the Copilot Plus PCs, just really making it easy for developers to bring their AI innovations and just amaze their customers on Windows.
Nuri?
Yeah, I think it's time to refresh the PCs for developers. So I will just say, like, this is a tremendous opportunity to everyone in this room and also watching online to think about, like, how do they catch the next wave of AI on the PCs? Because this is going to, like, create a lot of opportunities for them to grow their business, maybe to unleash some, like, new powers with the power of AI. I think the Khan Academy is a good example how you can help education. Yesterday's Imagine Cup winners from Turkey, they did an amazing job. Like, I mean, I'm so proud as a Turkish citizen. So, like, I believe, like, that will be massive opportunities in the market with AI PC. So I'm just, I'm saying that developers should get hands-on experience with those devices.
If we have students out there, our students that sat and watched Imagine Cup, opportunity.
Exactly.
Opportunity.
Exactly.
You have homework to do. We're going to do things. So, Rob, we have talked a lot over the last couple of days, and we've spent quite a bit of time together. Let's try to distill down some of those key points that you want to make.
Yeah, I think I want to really double down on the developer readiness.
Yeah.
We want to lower down the friction, lower down the bar for developers to start developing on our platform. And we want to meet them where they are. If they are PyTorch fans, they should be able to use PyTorch. Onyx is something we really love. Both Intel and Microsoft work together in developing, and it's sort of the foundation of AI PC. And you can have a consistent experience, go from, train a model using PyTorch, get it deployed in Onyx from CPU, GPU, and NPU, and then being able to run it in a reliable, secure manner, being able to run it from cloud to device, WebNN, Keicha mentioned earlier. You want to write apps which are ready for that web aspect too. And lastly, like I mentioned earlier, you have all this tool ecosystem for developers to start using to be able to identify issues around accuracy. When they start deploying, they will suddenly see that cat becomes a dog. Right? Accuracy issues, right?
Yeah,
and
sure.
We've all been dealing with that a lot. So we have the tool and the framework for developers to really make their development time faster, right? And thirdly, are all these tools available like Pix, which can help them root cause bottleneck issues. We call this thing performance cliffs. Suddenly, you change something and the performance really drops. So being able to have access to those tools, that helps you deploy faster. So that's where I think my mind is, that we are really ready for developers to start engaging on AI PC and get the benefits of responsiveness, reliability, and security.
Very cool, and tools available now. So for more information, you're gonna wanna head over to the featured partner section of the build.microsoft.com website. That's it for us, thank you all very much. We are going to a breakout session. Yes, we're going to a breakout session with Charles LaManna. So stick around. We've got more from Microsoft Build coming right up.